My teacher I got in mind, I will never forget her, man. It was Miss Adair. Thick ass black woman, man. It was nice as fuck too.
We already got that going? Alright. We're talking about fucking our high school teacher. Yeah, bro, I had this one. Another Spanish teacher I had in the high school. What was her name? Miss Stefani? That is the worst teacher ever. She was fine as hell though.
Stefanik.
What was her name?
Stefanik.
Is it Stefanik? Oh, yeah. You know her?
Her brother was my teacher.
Oh, for real? But she was fine, boy.
What, South?
Independence.
Oh, okay.
I wanted.
What up, bro?
Also, I can. We out here up in the frozen tundra.
Siberia.
Motherfucking, huh? You put curses on people, man?
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Hey, that's the spirit.
Like that bitch
that's
last
night. That's how the spirit works, too.
That shit was
funny. Oh, yeah, that was hilarious.
Adulterous hoe.
That shit was funny as hell. She got broke. She just laid there.
I think that was that happened yesterday. That's stupid.
My wife is prone to accidents. Okay. One of the clumsiest bitches I've ever known in my life, man. Literally. Literally, she's one of the clumsiest. No, she's the clumsiest woman I've ever known in my life.
That's messed up, man.
She falls every time, man. Every
breaking ankles.
Yep, she broke her ankle and her foot before. Two separate
incidents. I remember
incidents.
That time she had the cast on her leg.
You remember that?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I forgot you seen that. Yeah. Hell no.
Yeah, man. I feel bad for her.
Yeah, she got terrible luck, man. I told her I cursed her ass. So, I did, though.
He cursed his old woman.
I did, though.
What's shit. Up, Esau? All
right. Faggot.
Wisdom of Solomon. 5:15, but the righteous live forevermore. The reward also is with the Lord, and the care of them is with the Most High.
Oh yeah.
Therefore shall they receive a glorious kingdom and a beautiful crown from the Lord's hand, for with his right hand shall he cover them, and with his arm shall protect them.
What's that, the perks of the kingdom when the Lord gets here? Like what we was talking about, you want to fuck your teacher? You probably had enough having her in the kingdom.
Oh, yeah.
That's part of that reward when the Lord gets
that's
you.
That's part of the reward.
Yep. The women. The booty.
Yep.
The scripture. Don't the scriptures call it booty?
Yep.
We making that up or what? You tell me that.
Yeah, booty. You get some booty. That's the spoils reward.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
So I'm fascinated with all kinds of different women. You got crushes on bitches.
Like ice cream.
Yeah, bro.
Different flavors.
He dropped
something in the middle of the street. I don't want nobody to tell him. You see it?
Yeah. Yes. Go get it before it gets ran over. Hey, dude.
That's all right, bro. That's the good Samaritan way of doing things. You gotta be a good Samaritan.
There's deodorant.
Yeah.
Deodorant? Careful, Lisa. Hey, you talking about some deodorant? Bro, my mom made some homemade deodorant. It's all natural.
Yeah. I got the YouTube station channel with the ladies teaching how to do it.
Dude, it's the most amazing shit I've ever used.
Straight up?
I put it on my armpits. Bro, that shit lasts forever. I mean, it don't have no smell to it.
Right. But it holds your funk.
You don't get funk.
Oh, my God, man.
It's just amazing. Believe me, I even tested it. Didn't take a shower for a day.
Right.
There's no smell.
I hesitate on making it, man. I don't know why, man.
It's amazing.
But I did the toothpaste, though.
Oh, yeah. She made some homemade toothpaste, too.
Yeah, that toothpaste is amazing, man. It's amazing.
I haven't tried it yet.
Yeah, that toothpaste, baking soda.
But you made some toothpaste.
Yeah, you can make your own. It's better than the fluoridated shit. Yeah. And plus, that fluoridated shit don't, it's not abrasive. It's going to scrub your teeth.
Fluoridated toothpaste. Gives you brain damage.
Yeah, that's right. Fucks you up.
That shit fuck up your bone marrow too.
Mm-hmm. See that baking soda scrubs your teeth.
Yeah.
You know, you're going to have to worry about having a
That's why you get that gritty, the baking soda. That's that shit sprinkling against your teeth.
Yep, yep.
She,
yep.
Got, she made some shit where she had put some calcium in it.
Yeah, you use baking soda, you use coconut oil, and there's, I forgot the thing you call, well, you can use tea tree oil. Well, whatever you want to do to give you a mini flavor,
yeah.
Or, you know.
Yeah.
You can clean your teeth too with a sage plant. It's a certain type of sage. And you take the leaves and it cleans your teeth. It's got some grit on the leaf and it cleans your teeth real good.
You think Moses and King David and Solomon, you think they used Colgate?
You're right. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
And they wasn't walking around with dookie breath either.
Right.
They kept
clean. Yeah, that's
they
right.
Stayed clean.
That's right.
And my teeth, they all fucked up. I used to drink all, before I used to drink all kinds of fucking pop, smoked cigarettes.
Mm-hmm,
that
mm-hmm.
shit fucks your teeth
up. Yeah, it stains your shit. And then you gargle after you brush it with the baking soda. You gargle with peroxide.
Yeah, peroxide. I clean my teeth.
Yeah,
salt too.
I use peroxide.
Yeah, that peroxide blocks that bacteria that causes bad breath. You know, plus if you got teeth that has maybe a cavity, it actually helps eat away at that. The cavity itself. Then, if you want, bacteria. Take the time out to do it. Gargle with swishing coconut in your mouth for like 10-15 minutes every day, man. And you know, hey, you talking about you have a tooth pain, it's gone the next day, man. Because it's that bacteria that's backing up in your mouth, man.
Yeah, peroxide works wonders
for peroxide,
toothpaste.
That's the baddest shit, man. That's the baddest shit, man, that
There's
peroxide.
Another, I think it's like you chew on, I think a ginger stick.
Oh,
ginger stick too.
I did that once. I had a toothache. I tried some ginger. To be honest with you, the best thing to work for me was peroxide, salt, and ibuprofen.
Salt is abrasive too. Help eat away at that plaque. And but that mouthwash that Esau makes, that helps bacteria grow.
It dries your gums out.
Yeah, it helps it. It helps that bacteria.
When you got a toothache, don't ever. I'd make that mistake. I kept gargling mouthwash and it fucked up my gums.
Yeah, that's a man.
Dried them out. It made my gums turn all white.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he's so clever, man. He know what he's doing. That's why they made it illegal for them dentists to be into that natural health and all that. They get fined or lose their license.
Hey,
suggested health remedies and
hey,
shit.
Hold this sign for a minute. I got to throw this away.
You want to remove that? Damn Esau, man. Esau ain't shit, man. But he's clever, man. What's the purpose of the devil, man?
I got it.
He got that wisdom.
To deceive you with that health, too.
The wisdom of Solomon. You know what that says? Oh, you finish that, and we'll get wisdom of Solomon. Where you at?
What you want wisdom? Which one is wisdom?
You talking about the natural cures. You might as well get the physician's prescription.
Okay.
You know where that's at?
Yeah, I think there's two of them. One Ecclesiastes and, is it wisdom of Solomon?
Yeah, I think it's wisdom of Solomon.
Solomon 5:16. Therefore shall they receive a glorious kingdom and a beautiful crown.
Just read it again, bro.
Therefore shall they receive a glorious kingdom and a beautiful crown from the Lord's hand. With his right hand shall he cover them, and with his arm shall he protect them. He shall take to him the jealousy for a complete armor, and make the creature his weapon for the vengeance of his enemies. He shall put on righteousness.
Oh, Salakia, hold up. Get Ecclesiastes. My fault. You was right. Ecclesiastes 38.
It's 38. Yeah, that's where I was.
Well, I was thinking it wasn't with Solomon. My fault.
That's all right, though. That's all right.
He should put on righteousness as a breastplate and true judgment instead of a helmet. He shall take holiness for an invisible shield. His severe wrath shall be sharpened for a sword, and the world shall fight with him against the unwise. Then shall the right hand and thunderbolts go abroad, and from cloud, as from a well-drawn bow, shall they fly to the mark. Hailstones full of wrath shall be cast.
That's a hellfire. that's some fire and brimstone. So when you ain't right the Most High, you gonna eat missiles. You gonna fire brimstone. Fire and brimstone is gonna rain on your head. go ahead.
Y'all mentioned those plants and shit that they use it for health purposes, dental hygiene, stuff like that. This is Ezekiel 47 and 12. I got that Ecclesiastes at home too.
Hey, we hold this. I'm gonna get his bag.
And by the river upon the bank thereof, on this side and on that side, shall grow all trees for meat, whose leaves shall not fade, neither shall the fruit thereof be consumed. It shall bring forth new fruit according to its month. Because their waters, they issue out of the sanctuary, and the fruit thereof shall be for meat, and the leaf thereof for medicine.
Oh, yeah, there you go, the leaf for medicine.
Okay.
So all these different plants out here, not all of them, but a lot of plants have medicinal purposes. They don't want you using natural cures. They want to get you on some pharmaceuticals.
Yeah.
Okay. While we was talking about that last night, the word pharmaceutical comes from the Greek word pharmakia, which is translated as witchcraft in the King James Bible.
Mm. Mm.
Like when you read, what's that in that book of Galatians? What was that, 5 and 28? I could look it up. I'll look it up. When Paul mentioned witchcraft, when you look it up in Greek, it says pharmakia. Yeah, that's all the different potions. And half the medicines you get from the doctors, you've seen the commercials. They tell you about they list about 100 side effects real quick.
Yeah. If you go blind.
It make you go blind, you get diarrhea, make you bleed out your eyes.
Make you impotent.
Hell, what the fuck? Yeah, night terrors.
Why did you throw that on me?
Suicidal. Thank you, suicidal thoughts.
Yeah, ain't that something?
Yeah. But you want to take that shit.
Yeah, I'm going to give you some shit that gives me suicidal thoughts, night terror, and diarrhea.
And bleed out your ass.
Fucking be on the commercial, just poking his butt now.
Yeah.
Happy as can be.
Yeah, because they in La La Land, bro.
right. Dumbasses. Yeah, Esau got some bad shit out there, bro. This is Ecclesiastes, Apocrypha 38:12.
Then start at the top.
Start at one?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah, right, okay. Honor a physician with the honor due unto him for the uses which he may have of him. For the Lord hath created him. For of the Most High cometh healing, and he shall receive honor of the king. The skill of the physician shall lift up his head, and in the sight of great men he shall be in admiration.
What does the word physician mean?
Physician.
What does it mean? It means natural. It literally means natural. That's where you get the word physics. Physics is the study of the natural world. You know what I'm saying? Like the laws of physics, that's the laws of nature.
Right.
They're like the word nature itself means nutrients. Nature, to nurture, nutrients. Physics means natural. You know what I'm saying? Gives you all the basic nutrients and everything that you need to keep yourself healthy.
That's right.
He's actually the best medicine is a healthy diet. If you eat right, you don't need no fucking medicines.
You don't know.
Food is medicine. You know what I'm saying?
That's right. Eat the right foods, keep your gut clean. That's 70% of your immune system.
Yeah, your gut. Because most people, they chew, you know, that swine's flesh. They drink nothing but acidic shit, like, you know, drink a pop all day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, lately I drink nothing but water, mostly.
Popping Kool-Aid.
All that sugar. I've been putting too much sugar in my coffee. I gotta stop. You know, drinking coffee is healthy for you. To drink a couple cups a day. They say coffee with no sugar helps fight diabetes. You know, that's natural. The coffee bean, that can help fight diabetes.
The Lord hath created medicines out of the earth, and he that is wise would not abhor them.
Right. So, only a goddamn fool would abhor some natural cures. I try to tell people all the time, like, man, you sick, don't be going to the doctor. Here, you going to the doctor, you can get you some natural cures. You can look up on the internet for some natural cures. They be like, the internet is bullshit. That's lies. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to the doctor. They look at you like you're stupid.
Right. And what does doctor mean? Basically deceiver, to adulterate, to change.
Yeah, one of the definitions of it means to patch something up.
Yeah. Devils, man. That's why they walk around with that Seducius?
Well, yeah, the Seducius. Yeah, because the doctors, they used the symbol of the Seducius. That comes from Hermes. The Hermes, the symbol was the Seducius. The same thing Thoth used.
Israelites, bro. You familiar with the Israelites? You an Israelite?
All right, my man.
Every now and then.
Every now and then.
That's sad. That's sad.
What you call that straddle?
I'm like being lost.
What side you on now?
I'm on his side. God's side.
That's right. Well, you can listen if you want, man.
Well, it's for you anyway. Was not the water made sweet with wood, that the virtue thereof might be known? And he hath given men skill, that he might be honored in his marvelous works.
Yeah, right now we was talking about, before you came up, we was talking about the doctors in these hospitals. Do you know all the doctors in them hospitals, they're all, literally, they're like witches.
Like purges, I know.
They take, yeah.
The doctors, the lawyers.
There you go. The whole spectrum.
The police.
There you go.
Right. Yeah, the prison, the air, all that, I already know.
Right, they all in cahoots with each other.
Right,
yep.
Right.
Yep.
That's why when you see them sometimes, and you say hi to them, they keep moving like this.
They're on the seat. Why we curse them out. We put curses on them. You know what I'm saying?
They think they're above you anyway.
Yeah, they look down upon us.
I'm homeless, right?
Right.
I sleep outside.
Right.
And I know the Lord been with me so preciously. I should have been frozen.
Okay. That's true.
Drinking, drugging, drunk, turning up, not caring, cursing people out, beating people up.
Right.
I'm not 18, I'm 36 now.
Yeah, you still a young man. Yeah, right. But he do look out people, you know. Times like this, when the weather drops to 0 degrees, you know, somebody looking out for you.
Oh yeah, because I was walking, and I asked some dude for some change. He's like, oh, I bought you something to eat. He told me this is
you good.
A restaurant.
Some manly shit up here.
Feel cold.
How you want.
Feel cold?
Yeah.
Man, the burger's only this big. But it cost you $15.
What?
Yeah.
Must be good then.
That's good.
What's the name of it?
Feel cold. It's on this side of the street.
Let me try that out.
And they got the home cut fries.
Hey, I gotta try it then.
Man, for that, the fries was $9.
Yeah, right. Damn, that's Eastern.
Yeah, that's
Eastern. Hey, can I spit one?
Huh?
Can I spit one?
Do what you know. Go ahead, man.
I ask the Lord to forgive me for my sins, because I don't know when this world is going to end. So that's why I keep Jesus as my Lord and Savior. And I ask him to forgive me for my bad behaviors, because living by the flesh is not the way to live. Pray to the Lord and take care of your children. Having all these sinful thoughts up in your mind only leave you behind at the end of time. So that's why I say this around, trying to reach the people of this nation. Didn't you know he's God's favorite creation? That's why he made us in his own image and rulers over everything. But we don't know how to act, running around ready to attack like the demons out of the pits. And if you're not blessed, you'll be giving Satan a hot tongue kiss.
My man. All right, man.
All right, y'all.
Jake always wants to shine when he see a camera.
Yeah, that's right.
Every time Jake see a camera, he want to get a shine on.
That's the cleanest homeless guy I've ever seen.
Yeah, he got clean shaven hair.
Yeah, a lot of them. I mean, hey, remember dude? Remember Derek?
Yeah.
Well,
he got that. It's a hustle. They got it down.
Mm-hmm. Derek is always clean.
Because they figured out how to live for free and to live. Because really, a lot of homeless people are. They're more free than the average person.
Yeah, that's right. They went right. You know.
Remember that one dude we met? He was a train hopper.
Oh
my God!
Hey,
that's
my dude, bro. He came up here. He's like, I just got this sandwich that's still in the package out of the trash.
Out the trash, yeah.
He's like, shit, I eat good.
As a matter of fact, I think it was one of them trash cans where he got it out of.
Yeah, it was like a brand new, still in the package. He's like, I'm about to hit this train. I'm gonna go out to Cali. Yeah, they hop trains, bro. They travel to homeless people. They be hopping trains. They go all over the country, man.
Mm-hmm.
And here we just doing nothing, sitting in the same spot.
Yeah, they live a less stressful life.
Right.
Until winter hits.
That takes a certain spirit. That's a certain kind of spirit to be like that, man.
I think it'd be kind of fun.
Yeah, it sounds fun.
Yeah. You know what? That's the spirit, though, because dude walks up and we're giving him the his solution, his physician. We've been his physician in this world.
And he's already out of there. Dude.
Yeah, he's gone. That's why he kept going. This was the solution to all his problems right here.
Sometimes I feel like doing that. I feel like just get rid of all my possessions and just roaming the goddamn country teaching the word.
Yeah, I feel like doing that all the time.
You know what I'm saying?
I feel like doing that all the time.
If I end up starving to death, the Lord say don't take no thought for what you need. Hey, people probably will take care of you. You know what I'm saying?
Never know. Never know. Never know. What was I at? Okay, this is verse 7. With such doth he heal men and taketh away their pains.
Oh, yeah. That's what them... because just like the Native American Indians, they didn't have to get no goddamn Obamacare. You know what I'm saying? They knew all the natural cures. Oh. Most of the natural cures we got today, we got them from Gad. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Like I was talking about the sage and all that. The sage was one of them favorite plants.
They didn't even know of a flu.
Yeah,
they
had no common cold. Yeah, you know, you can't even take violets. You know, violets grow every goddamn where. You can take violets and make it like a little violet tea, and it cures headaches.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they had their diet down pat. No broken bones, no none of that shit. Body was getting all the calcium it needs.
Even if you do break a bone, you can make a cast out of mud. You ever seen that?
Nah.
You make a mud cast? Adobe brick cast? Yeah, bro.
Like a clay cast.
Yeah, out of clay.
Like that,
you can make a cast out of clay and it hardens on your leg.
That's pretty much what it is, basically. Yeah. Some, you know. Of such doth the apothecary make a confection.
Hold up, my fault. Then you got other plants too. But you got the plants that heal you. But then you get you other plants, like get you some lavender. Here there's people spending all this money on some bug spray, the Hoff, to repel the mosquitoes.
Mm-hmm.
All you gotta get you some lavender. Instead of spraying all them chemicals, get some lavender.
Fleas hate lavender.
You put lavender, just rub it on your body, you ain't nothing gonna touch you.
Yep. Fleas hate it.
And it smells good too.
Yep. That's probably why they hate it.
Yep.
Like it's a fact that demons hate certain smells.
They said they hate sage. They would take the sage, and they said the sage wards off the evil spirits.
Yeah, right.
What is it?
And Tobit, what's the demon's name? Asmodeus.
Asmodeus. Asmodeus.
When Tobit took the
The liver.
That's one of the top demons, bro. Oh, and another thing too is that when they sealed the demon up in Egypt.
Yeah, he was bound.
He was bound in Egypt. That tells you the Egypt is the center of the evil spirits. You know what I'm saying?
I think he was in it now.
So he sealed that demon up in Egypt. That's why you watch that cartoon Thundercats. And Mumra, you remember Mumra?
Nah.
He be like ancient spirits of evil.
I used to love Thundercats.
And it was all Egyptian gods.
Yep.
He was up in a pyramid.
Wow.
He's in a pyramid calling on the ancient spirits of evil.
Right.
Because the ancient spirits of evil is the those false Egyptian gods. You know what I'm saying? That was a dude.
Yeah, you tell about when he's walking. It's walking. That's a dude.
That was a dude. You gotta be careful, boy.
That's why this bitch gotta go.
Yeah, that's why.
You only know what's walking up and down the streets.
I know, you gotta be careful before you see a bitch walking down the street. Everybody's like, oh, she look good. You get up close, you're like, ah!
Hollywood's full of that shit.
Yeah, oh, man. I was stayed out in L.A. for a minute, boy. That's some freaky shit. There's some freaky shit out here too, though, man.
Hell yeah, there is.
Oh, up here on the campus.
You see downtown, they got the rainbow flags all over the place.
Rainbow flags all up in downtown, bro. What's up with that? So not just any person can go put flags up on the poles. If I went and put my flags on the poles, I'm going to go to jail.
Exactly.
So that's the government that's putting that shit up there, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Because that tells you them faggots... They're running shit. You got literally we got devil worshiping faggots running the government.
Damn right.
Literally.
Damn right.
They worship Satan. There's no other way to explain it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. In his works, there is no end. And from him is peace over all the earth. My son, in thy sickness, be not negligent. Boy, man, that's kind of weird. It says my son, not my son and daughter.
that's how the Bible works. The Bible always says my son. It's always talking about the man. Because this is the book was written for men. That's right. Women can read it. They can learn too. But
ever learn it,
it's
but
a manly
never able
book.
To come to the truth.
Right. Because every time a woman read the scripture, she gotta ask you, what does this mean, baby? She don't understand it anyway. It could be something simple, she still don't understand it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. She can look it up and everything, still won't
get it.
Yeah.
That's why a woman will believe in all kind of crazy doctrines.
Yeah.
They'll believe anything you tell them.
Yeah.
If you told them that the Lord was an alien in the front of planet Pluto, and she believe it, man.
You see they eating all that shit up there, Polite teaching them?
Yeah, because Polite said what planet he said he was from?
Frisk.
They just made some shit up.
Mm-hmm.
That shit don't even goddamn exist. Mm-hmm. Talking about he from an alien planet. He got followers.
Right. Mostly women, too.
He got multiple wives.
He's from a Polite.
Yeah.
No light.
So this dude's bugged out of his mind. He actually said he from an alien planet, got abducted by aliens, and he actually is being taken serious by people.
That's right.
That's right. Crazy.
That's right. That's right.
That's what I'm saying. They'd rather deal with that bullshit.
Bullshit.
That's bullshit.
That's beyond bullshit.
Bullshit.
That's motherfucking high on PCP type shit.
I'd rather deal with the bullshit than the actual truth, which is magnificence.
Exactly. Yeah. Because they be trying to have debates with the scriptures like it's all mythical.
Mm-hmm.
Mythical.
But he's talking about an alien planet.
Right. Yeah, yeah. And he's talking about alien planets.
And then refer to this as that spooky shit.
That's spooky.
Yeah, spooky. Yeah, that's kind
of
creepy.
Actually, this the Bible is kind of spooky to a devil.
It sure is.
You should be spooked.
That's right.
You should be very afraid.
Very.
it's a scary.
Yeah, we were talking about that last night. That Horus Isis story is creepy.
Break that down. Horus, say so, fuck it. It's nothing but incest. Ancient Egypt was built on incest. Because Osiris was married to Isis, his goddamn sister. And then, what was it? Osiris got chopped up into a bunch of pieces.
Yeah, by Seth.
Yeah, by Seth, thrown into a coffin. Then he became part of a tree or something. What the fuck? That don't even make. And then Isis went looking. He got chopped into a bunch of pieces. Isis went looking for him and found all the pieces but a penis. But then somehow, did she get his penis?
She just wanted to get his penis.
And then she did. I guess she got herself pregnant. And then that out came Horus, the son of incest. That don't even make no sense. And then people try to say the Bible is based on Egypt.
Yep.
What is this madness? If the Bible is an Egyptian book, show me that part in the Bible.
Damn, don't the Bible condemn Egypt?
It sure the fuck does.
The scripture tells you go down to Egypt.
Oh, I got a scripture. Let me look it up.
Yeah.
Yeah, says Matt, show me the Bible where Osiris got put in a coffin, became a tree, chopped up into pieces. You people are out your fucking mind with that shit.
Yeah,
saying the Bible's Egyptian.
Yeah, that's some bullshit right there. They eat it up, though. They eat it up. But they can't accept Jonah being swallowed by a great fish.
Yeah.
You know? They tried to clown on that.
Right.
But made themselves look stupid.
There's other bugged out stories too.
At least a fish actually exists.
Yeah, that's right.
Motherfucking
big ass fish.
Motherfuckers getting chopped up into pieces and growing into a tree.
Yeah,
come on.
Another bugged out story of I think of like a child or something getting stranded on that island. There's like a big gigantic snake or something crazy like that. Something bugged
out. It is all bugged out. Look, I got a scripture. Exodus 12 and 12. For I will pass through the land of Egypt this night. Oh, this is the Passover scripture. I will pass through the land of Egypt this night and will smite all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both man and beast. And against all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgment. I am the Lord. It said against all the gods of Egypt. So fuck your Egyptian gods. And the Most High hated goddamn Egypt so much, not only did he kill all the firstborn people, he even killed the animals.
The firstborn, yeah.
Because they was heathen. They had the spirit of the heathen on them, bro. Because you know how an animal take on the spirit of his master. You got a dog, it kind of resembles you in the spirit. You know what I'm saying? It takes on your characteristics.
Man, best friend.
Yeah. So just a heathen's animal is going to act like a heathen. Because that's all it knows. You know what I'm saying?
Scripture. Psalms 33 and 10. The Lord bringeth the counsel of the heathen to naught.
And the counsel of the heathens, those Egyptians, the heathens.
He maketh the devices of the people of none effect.
Yeah, so that Egyptian doctrine has got no effect. You know what I'm saying? It accomplishes nothing.
The counsel of the Lord standeth forever.
Right, the counsel of the Lord stands forever. That's why there's always going to be brothers teaching this word. So what's that, the gospel, the Lord's, what's that, Matthew 24? He said, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word shall not pass away. You know what I'm saying? Because his word is eternal. Don't nobody even know the words of ancient Egypt. Them words ain't going out throughout the earth. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
The thoughts of his heart to all generations. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord.
Can y'all quote any Egyptian scriptures for me? I bet we got an Egyptologist out here. If we asked them to give us just one Egypt scripture, they couldn't even do it. Go ahead.
And the people whom he hath chosen for his own inheritance.
Yeah, that's Israel. Israel inherit the kingdom. Keep going.
The Lord looketh from heaven. He beholdeth all the sons of men from the place of his habitation. He looketh upon all the inhabitants of the earth. He fashioneth their hearts alike. He considereth all their works. There is no king saved by the multitude of an host. A mighty man is not delivered by much strength. And horse is a vain thing for safety. Neither shall he deliver any by his great strength. Behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy.
Yeah, on those that fear him and hope for his mercy. That's key, man. Oh, go ahead. Oh, yeah, you got to fear the Most High. A lot of these fools, they just walk around like everything's all good. They in a comfort zone all the time. Like, ain't nothing ever going to happen to them. Like, they are mortal beings. They go to Heshi again. Fucking freak.
To deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine.
Oh, like we was talking about last night. We was watching that video. We was talking about that video we watched. That adulterous woman was at the hair salon getting her hair did.
Mm-hmm.
And then her boy, cause she had committed adultery and her boyfriend just wrote, and she was in there just probably running her mouth and having a good time talking, gossiping.
Yeah.
And her husband came up there and just pulled out a gun and just emptied a goddamn clip right in her goddamn brains.
That's right.
Splattered her brains all over the fucking place.
That's right. Probably in there talking about how she just blew her new man.
Tell me, yeah, he's no good anyway, so I got me a new.
Yeah.
I got me a new man.
Got me a new dick.
Yeah, I got me a new dick.
Dumb bitches.
Like these bitches got caught in packs.
So that, yeah. So, yeah, adulterous whore don't fear the Lord, man. That's why he'll bring his vengeance on your ass, man. Because you commit adultery, you deserve to get put to death for that, man. Especially if you don't repent. If you bragging about it. Because bitches will brag about it, too. Oh, yeah, there's more to that?
That's no, a good point.
That's some fire right there. pick, because these hoes ain't shit, man.
Proverbs 12 and 2. A good man obtaineth favor of the Lord, but a man of wicked devices will he condemn.
Yep. That's a good one.
Oh, here it is. This is more on Egypt, man, about their homosexual acts and shit with whores and Seth.
Yeah, it's some weirdo shit, eh?
Yeah. Known as the contendings of Horus and Seth, the myth explicitly details the attitudes to homosexual intercourse.
Hold on, wait till this goddamn bus leaves, man. That's when you get to the good part and the coda bus rolling up.
Yeah, that's Satan working, man.
Yeah.
They don't want this shit coming out.
Oh, that's a fucking red light, too.
Oh, shit, those are cursed.
Yeah. They already cursed, look at
them.
Oh, you... Fuck it, you probably... That camera's video. Why, Coca-Cola's gotta be loud as hell, too, huh? Raggedy ass shit, man. Oh, shit, my
fault.
Well, I'll probably...
You be trying to drive down the street and shit, Coca-Cola's always blocking traffic.
Well, you see all that pollution in the air, that shit, the smoke be coming off of it.
Yeah. That's really all these cars, actually.
Yeah. We got that big ass black cloud in this morning's atmosphere.
I'd be happy with riding horses, man. Homeside gave us a natural form of transportation.
Right. Horse, donkey, camel.
Yeah, all kind of different animals you can ride.
Yeah.
This is known as a contending of Horus and Seth. The myth explicitly details the attitude to homosexual intercourse.
Ugh.
Whether the tale details that of rape, seduction, or reciprocal sex depends upon which text is used. Pyramid text 1036 records.
Oh, they always talk about the pyramid text. That's a popular one.
Very popular, yeah.
Yep.
1036 records a reciprocal reproach to homosexual desire. Horus had penetrated Seth's anus with his This is wild, man.
What the fuck?
Horus has penetrated Seth's anus with his seed.
With his seed, he busted a nut up in his ass.
Wait a minute. Seth has penetrated Horus's anus with his seed.
What the fuck?
So Seth impregnated Horus.
They probably had a child out of that too. You know how ancient Egypt does,
yeah,
it, bro.
Yep.
He got a C-section.
right.
Papyrus. It came out his dick.
That's crazy. Papyrus Chester Beatty I, dating to 20th Dynasty reign of Ramses V, takes a more aggressive reproach. After a banquet, Seth is said to rape Horus in order to shame him and take the crown from his brother Osiris at night.
That's some prison shit, bro.
Yeah.
You shame someone, you rape a motherfucker? God damn.
That's like century shit, bro.
They had a little Debbie sitting on his bed when he got back.
That little Debbie.
You see them?
At night, Seth let his member become stiff and he inserted it between the thighs of Horus.
Oh, man.
Yet within the Petri Papyrus fragment, whatever, dating to the late Middle Kingdom, the men are shown as lustful and seductive, proclaiming what has been described as the first recorded chat-up line, how lovely are your buttocks and how muscular your thighs.
Wow.
What the fuck is that?
This
shit
is crazy, man. What is constant throughout each of the representations of the tale is degrading of the passive participants. In each tale, it is said that Horus placed his hands between his thighs and caught the semen of Seth.
No, man. So he caught his semen.
Yep.
That's some freaky shit, man.
For which Isis severs Horus' hand and throws it into the Nile. After fashioning Horus a new hand, Horus is instructed to spread his semen upon Seth's lettuce.
On his lettuce. Oh, I heard too that there's a tradition in ancient Egypt, and they would put semen in their salads. They'd bust a nut and make salad dressing out of them.
That's crazy.
That's probably where
mayonnaise comes from. Eggs.
Oh, that's nasty, man.
Yeah. After fashioning Horus a new hand, Horus is instructed to spread his semen upon Seth's lettuce, to which unsuspectedly Seth devours.
He's eating his nut.
Some man glaze.
What the fuck?
Salad nut. Salad dressing nut.
Man, that's like your boy. That's like we were watching Caligula.
Yeah.
And they was using a nut. Shit, bitch had a whole bowl of nut. Just jacking off into a bowl. And she was using nut for a skin lotion. Oh.
Yeah. Right there in the movie. Right there in the movie.
Nah, niggas ain't never read nothing about that.
Right. But they all worship the same
guys. Well, they are faggots. Because I forgot which faggot it is that actually defends why the Egyptians play with dicks and shit.
Oh, yeah.
The faggot.
What's his name?
The ball head with the tail.
Almost something. Shaka Almost.
Yeah, that's him.
That's him.
A straight faggot.
That's a weird
one. He got a whole hour, 2 hour video talking about it.
He a straight faggot.
That motherfucker.
Talking about why they play with dicks and shit. Faggot shit, man.
Well, he looked like...
He was called out anyway. The elders and the apostles called him out anyway on that faggot shit.
Yeah, he was straight faggot.
Yeah, man. Come on, bro. Just one look at...
makeup and shit.
Just one look at him, bro. That's all you need.
That's right.
You just know.
What's that? Isaiah, when the looks bears witness
against the countenance.
Them? Yeah,
Let
me look that up. We'll see if I can find that.
Yep.
That's on the CDC sign.
Is that Isaiah 1?
Oh, that is on. Oh, no, Isaiah 3.
Is it 3?
Okay, yeah. I'm going to get that, I know, that's a good one.
Just like we knew that motherfucker just walked by. You know, we knew he was a fucking, it was a man, you know.
Just by the accounts.
Yeah.
I mean... from a distance, they might get you.
And but she's an African.
Get those that want to be got.
Because the dudes, too, bro, they be getting breast implants. They be getting butt cheek implants.
Yep. They go all the way, get the dick chopped off. They take the female hormones. You know?
On the Blitz, they was talking about this guy had to get a penis reduction.
Damn.
He just said his cock was too big. He had a condition. And the DJ was like, what kind of condition is that called? Awesomeness?
Right. There's a medical condition that these babies be getting. I can't remember what it is, but it does cause your penis to grow abnormal.
You get a big ass dick?
Yeah, get a bit too big of a dick. Yet you can't, you can't fuck normal with a
dick. You're scared, bitch.
Yeah. A woman I just read it this morning on Drudge that a woman divorced her husband because his dick was too big.
Oh, my dear.
Yep. Yep, that's wild.
Damn.
That's wild.
Yeah, cause
that's wild. I was
you split a bitch up, but that's like on that movie we was watching, Goodbye Uncle Tom.
Right.
They brought your boy, what's his name, Jason, up in there.
Right.
Fuck the hoes. He split a bitch wide open.
Right. Hell no. I met this bitch up in Worthington, man, and she wouldn't let me fuck her for shit, but she just blew my shit, man. She's like, I ain't letting you fuck me. Now, I ain't got no monster. I ain't trying to talk about my dick, but I ain't got no monster's dick, man. And I ain't making that up, man. She wouldn't let me fuck her, man. She was just blowing me, man.
But there's some bitches, though, they like them big. They like to fuck horses. They'll bust a fist.
Hey, this Sean.
Your hand frozen?
I gotta go piss.
Go piss by the tree.
Talking about dicks, got the brother one a piss.
Do like Mario. Y'all play Mario 64? And on the snow level, if you stand by a tree and don't move, it'll start pissing.
Oh, you kidding me?
Nah. On Mario 64, go to the snow level, just stand by a tree and just wait.
Oh, wow.
It'll start pissing. It'll be like this.
Wow.
That's my shit.
Wow. What the fuck?
I got a scripture. Isaiah 3:8. For Jerusalem is ruined and Judah is fallen. You know Judah's fallen, they talking about they Egyptian. Because their tongue and their doings are against the Lord. It was against Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai, to provoke the eyes of his glory. This is the one I think you wanted. The show of their countenance doth witness against them, and they declare their sin as Sodom.
Faggots.
Yep.
They hide it not. Woe unto their soul, for they have rewarded evil unto themselves. Say ye to the righteous that it shall be well with him, for they shall eat of the fruit of their doings.
The wicked shit, wicked act of homosexuality.
Yep.
Yep.
Woe unto the wicked, it shall be ill with him, for the reward of his hand shall be given him.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Oh, this is a good one too.
You get a faggot's reward.
As for my people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them.
Right, there you go, that Egyptology.
That's that Egypt shit they always talking about. The woman is God. They always say the woman is God.
Yep.
But that's just Egyptology, but all them pagan so-called religions are Well, they don't like being called religion. They're like, what is not a religion? It's spirituality. Well, whatever the fuck you call that shit, it's all based on a worshiping of a woman.
Yeah.
Okay, the same with the, because the Greek mythology, the Roman mythology, the Norse mythology, is all based on the same shit. You know what I'm saying? Because you got a sky god in each one of them, like with the Horus is a sky god. He's a, he's pretty much the same thing as fucking Zeus and Thor. And it's all the same shit. They all got the Queen of Heaven in all of them, too.
Yep.
Yeah, you got Isis, you got Diana, Minerva, Athena. What's the, you got Frey. What's the one, the Hebrew one, or the Canaanite one, Asherah. The Israelites always worshipped Asherah, which is a Queen of Heaven, same thing as Isis. So it's all paganism is all based on the worship of the woman, man. It's the feminine vibration, it's a feminine spirit.
One thing about that scripture too, it says women rule over, and it's not making it as a good thing.
No, it's definitely not.
That's a curse.
That's just like in America, you got women ruling over people. That's why you got, there's a lot of talk about Hillary Clinton running for president. Like we always talk about your girl, Sarah Palin. You know what I'm saying? Here it is, Sarah Palin. She's just a dumbass, good-looking bitch. You know what I'm saying? But she's dumb as a box of rocks.
Yep.
And that's like the conservatives' greatest leader.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
They
look up to this bitch like she's some kind of great leader. She's just retarded as hell.
Dumb as fuck.
Just dumb as fuck, bro. Just retarded. I mean, you always got women running shit. You go to any public school system, all the teachers are women, all the principals are women. Well, that bitch Jean Harris, the head of Columbus Public School.
This is facing criminal charges.
Yeah, facing criminal charges because she was lying about people's grade point averages, attendance. Taking money under the table. Because they was lying about the test scores and everything, because these children in Columbus, middle school, high school, they dumb as hell.
Yeah.
And this bitch lying about test scores she get money.
Yeah, they reach a certain average, they get grants.
Yeah, they get grants
from the government.
Man, these motherfuckers are stupid.
Yeah.
Retarded.
That's right. That's right. The scripture says, they that lead thee calls thee to err.
Yeah, they that leads thee. That's the woman.
That's
the
woman.
The woman is the main leader. That's why, because women rule over us. You go to a courthouse, you have a goddamn woman sitting on the bench. You know what I'm saying? A woman judge. And then, like I said, if you get a divorce with your woman, if you get a divorce, your bitch will just leave you. And she'll get custody. The woman will always get custody.
Clean your ass.
Always. And you got to pay child support and alimony.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I want to say this. You ever see that TV show that comes on called Snapped? It's called Snap. This bitch been dealing, they was married for 20 years. You know what I'm saying? And dude did everything for her. He was a cop.
Right.
Jake down there in Atlanta. This man did everything for this woman, right? For 20 years.
Damn.
So, out of nowhere, she just wanted to roll. That's out of nowhere.
That's how they do it, bro.
She was listening to her friends, probably, telling her, like, yeah, you know, if you get half of what he got and all that, blah, blah, blah. But what's funny is he had hired the Issachar, right, to take her ass out.
Wow.
For 20 years. And he just, like,
and then he got in trouble for it.
Yeah,
right, he did. Right. He went down.
Because that's a fucked up shit, because you'll kill a woman for adultery, and that's the law in the Bible. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
For 20 years, she just wanted to up. And I'm telling you, this man was, like, breaking bread with her more than he was doing his own sons.
Yeah, right.
And she just wanted to roll out.
And they act like he a criminal.
Right.
When this bitch committed a crime punishable by death.
Because he was doing what the American poster man is supposed to be doing for a woman. He was doing that shit.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Right.
How America is saying how a man should
be.
Yeah, he was doing all that shit.
Yeah.
And she just out of nowhere cold turkey wanted to divorce.
But you know what the bitch's excuse would be? he wasn't hitting it right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, don't find something.
Yeah. Or, you know, that's women just like new shit,
man. Yeah, they like new shoes.
They'll have it good and fuck it up for themselves and then think about it later when it's too late.
Yep.
Women's stupid. They're a child. Stupid. They're a child, man.
Yeah.
Just like a child, you punish a child, they go tear up their own shit, you know?
Because the thing is, we live in Satan's kingdom.
Yep.
When they got that liberty and that freedom to do whatever the fuck they want to do.
Sucking on everything.
Because in the kingdom, they ain't no shit like that going to go down, man.
Over much liberty?
Like back in the so-called Dark Ages, if you was a woman, you wasn't leaving your husband.
Yeah.
That never, it wasn't happening.
Yeah, it was unheard of.
Yeah, very unheard of. They would actually put you to death if you got caught committing adultery. All right? And the church didn't tolerate that shit. They're like, no, hell no, you ain't getting no divorce. Leaving your husband?
Yeah.
You didn't even think of even saying nothing like that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's crazy, man. We lived that world at one time, man.
Yeah. They called that the Dark Ages.
Yep.
And you notice too, back then, women was kind of looked down upon if they was single.
Israelite man knew to leave that bitch alone.
Yeah.
They didn't deal with her at all.
They ain't.
You know?
It was like, you ain't got no husband.
And they got married. And not only that, but they got married at a young age too.
Yeah, they sure did.
When they're 12, 13 years old, you getting married.
That explains why, you know, I mean, you had women going bugged out back then, but
12, 13.
I don't give a fuck what you want to hear.
I don't want to hear right.
Back then, that's the way it is.
That explains why back then there was way more mature. Because
it was more. It was more mature because they was 13, brought up. They was 14, brought up right.
You know,
brought up in the kitchen.
They was brought. They was raised in a God fearing household.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Right.
Yeah.
Even if that was a wicked ass family, they still was some righteous.
It was more than this shit.
Woo.
Because they still had that fear of the Lord. Because
the
whole system was built around the fear of the Lord.
Right. That's right.
I mean, the king said he got his power from the Most High.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
You know.
Plus,
what I'm saying?
It was a dark world back then. Them bitches knew better to go out there.
Yeah. Cause you get fucked.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway,
yeah. Back in them days, there wasn't no independent woman.
Yeah, right.
That shit wasn't going down
that. Shit. Here you go. This is Ecclesiastes 26, and I'm going to start at 8. A drunken woman and a gabber of brawl causes great anger.
Oh, yeah, one of these drunk-ass hoes. These bitches out here these days, they on all kind of drugs. Every woman you meet got pills in their pockets. Mm. They sniffing pills. They don't just take them. They sniff them.
Mm-hmm.
They sniffing pills.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? They get high. They getting fucked up. They taking all these drugs and shooting a porno. Getting their asshole blown out on camera for the whole world to see.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Foul as shit. A drunken woman in a gatherer or a brawl causes great anger, and she would not cover her own shame.
Yeah, she because these bitches got no shame, bro. They're like wild animals on the loose. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Esau, the devil, he gives them all this freedom, man, to do whatever the fuck they want.
Over that liberty. The whoredom of a woman may be known by in her haughty looks and eyelids.
That's why every woman you see got piles of makeup on her face. Always, you know what I'm saying? They always got to be dressed up and
I was walking down here and looking into that hairdressing spot.
Yeah.
Man.
It's an abomination.
Man, there's like a bride in there with some, I mean, these pants are super dumb tight.
Ooh.
She probably just bust out her shit.
Ooh.
It looked like a whorehouse.
Or like a straight harlot house.
All right,
bitches
right.
Got a tramp stamps.
Tramp stamps, yeah.
They got tramp stamps.
They even call them tramp stamps.
That's right.
They call them tramp stamps, yeah. They tattoos on their titties. Little tracks, little paw prints on their titties.
I mean, pussies.
Yeah, they got tattoos on your pussy, on their pussy.
To pierce pussies.
And they pierce their clit.
Yep.
That's an abomination.
That's crazy.
Mutilation.
I was reading a study the other day, man, how these bitches wear makeup, right? They'll go to bed without taking that shit off and go get up the next day and just cover it up with more makeup.
Yeah.
They say it's a study that women, they said it's one of the most things that women don't admit they
That's
do, but
why
they do
it. Crater faces.
Yep. That's that pork be fucking that shit up.
Looking like Freddy Krueger.
Yep, they sure do. The whoredom of a woman may be known in her haughty looks and eyelids. If thy daughter be shameless, keep her in straitly.
Right, because when you got a young daughter, especially if she start hitting that puberty, boy, it's like you better lock her ass up in a room.
Ooh, keep an eye on them.
Cause she's just like a cat. You ever see a cat go in heat?
Keep an eye, yeah.
They start going nuts,
hey, man. I had daughters, man. I had to put the fear in them to control that shit, man.
Yeah, that's a,
you know.
I pray I don't have any daughters.
You know.
I don't want to deal with that shit.
Yeah, it's a beautiful thing having daughters, though, man. It's a beautiful thing. Man.
I don't want to have them out here.
You know? Yeah, but you know.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. You know? Hey. I just like, that sounds like stress.
Yeah.
You know, that sounds like
work. Get them young. You get in their head young, man.
You don't wait
till they become a teenager before you start discipline. You get them young,
just
man.
Just like that says right there.
Yeah, that's right. That's exactly what we're going into. Yeah. If thy daughters be shameless, keep her in straitly, lest she abuse herself through over much liberty.
What do I mean by abuse? I'm talking about abusing her body.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Going out here partying. And they go
to liberty.
And they'll fuck anything they see, man.
Birth control.
Their mama ain't going to tell them, baby, you go out there fucking man after man. Your pussy going to start fucking stinking.
Nah, they going to encourage it. She's going to encourage it. She's like, you find you a man with some money. You know what I'm saying? You got to test the waters.
Test that water.
That means to go commit adultery.
You know what I'm saying? That sounds like some pimp shit.
Yeah, listen, these mothers, they pimp their own daughters. That is pimp shit.
Yeah.
They like mama signs. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Fine.
They're pimping their own daughters.
Yo,
and then if a mom doesn't like a man, she'll tell you, you gotta leave him.
Yeah.
You need to leave him. Yeah. He ain't no good.
Yeah.
And then if a young woman get pregnant, 13, 14, as a teenager, the mother will go have her get an abortion.
Yeah.
You wicked ass, old ass hoes.
Hey, Titus does a good job of explaining that shit to wicked, wicked ass hoes, man.
Yeah.
Look at him, whack him right there.
Thoroughbred.
That's a thick, yeah, that's a thoroughbred right there. A dick hoe.
Yeah, he said that right.
Watch over an impudent eye and marvel not if she's trespassed against thee.
Yeah, so you can't be all amazed.
Oh, fucked up.
Yeah,
you know, can't sleep, can't eat.
You good?
Yeah.
Can't sleep, can't eat, because this bitch went out and fucked your best friend, fucked her boss.
Like you can't be all amazed when your wife cheats on you.
That's right.
You can't be all amazed, like, I can't believe she did it.
How you expect that
right.
shit?
Right. Like, yeah, you expect it. It's like, in this kingdom, in this world we live in, you expect it. It's like, just a matter of time.
Sooner or later, yeah.
It's just a matter of fucking time before the hoe cheats on you.
Yep.
Later.
Yeah, because we live in Satan's kingdom, man.
It says, marvel not if she trespass against thee. She will open her mouth as a thirsty traveler when he has found a fountain.
I'm sorry. The first time I ever heard that scripture, bro, I lost it.
Yeah.
And I read this one to my sons too. They lost it. You know, when you little, stuff like that's funny as hell.
And drink of every water near her.
She drinking every water.
That's the test of waters.
Yeah, is she testing the waters?
Yeah, that's the test.
What they call it, basils.
Oh yeah, she's getting the bukkake.
Oh, that's Proverbs 7:10. Proverbs 7:10. And drink of every water near her, by every hedge will she sit down and open her quiver against every arrow.
For all you retards out there, quiver is her vagina, and all those arrows are penises.
Penetrating penises.
Right.
So, I mean, because this bitch is a hoes, man. No, so don't be all bugged out because a bitch is a hoe. It's just, we live in Satan's kingdom. All these women are hoes. Every woman you see walking by is a hoe. I mean, you can't tell me no different.
No matter how you slice it.
Yeah, no matter how you slice it. That's why we had that sign out here. We ain't got it today. But it says that over 110 million Americans are infected with STDs. That's half the damn population.
That's more than half.
Yeah,
more than half.
Well, those are old statistics too. So it's way more than that.
That's the ones that's recorded.
Yeah, that's the ones that's recorded.
Reported, yeah.
So yeah, so I mean, all these bitches, they got STDs. They don't give a fuck, man. We talked about this all the time too.
We're gonna make sure you get it too.
Oh yeah.
That's her whole objective. Make sure you get it too.
Yeah, like, oh, if I got it, you gotta get it.
That's right. That's right.
Shit, I know, man. I know it's real, man.
Let me read this. I was trying to find the one where she drink and she drinketh and swalloweth and thinks she does
says,
no evil.
I've done no wickedness.
That's
done no wickedness.
Proverbs 30, something.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're right. Good one. We used to bring that out on time. I used to bring that one out like every day.
Here you go. This is Proverbs 7:7. And beheld among the simple ones, I discern among the youth a young man void of understanding, passing through the street near her corner. And he went the way to her house in the twilight, in the evening, in the black and dark night. And behold, there met him a woman with the attire.
He trying to sneak a hoe in.
Up in harlot and subtle of heart. Well, it sounds more like she's this bitch is out actually looking for somebody to snatch up.
Yeah.
You know, looking for a victim. Like we were talking about, this bitch got disease. They want to make sure you catch it too.
Yeah.
Would you like them prostitutes too? Or, I mean, not even a prostitute. But one of these regular hoes are worse than a prostitute.
Way worse.
I got more respect for a prostitute than your average bitch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Way worse. Way worse. Prostitute ain't gonna be all loud. Boys go into it. She is loud and stubborn, and her feet abideth not in her house. Now is she without, now in the streets, and lieth in wait at every corner.
She lieth in wait at every corner.
It's like we're talking about.
That's an Israelite woman, too.
Yeah.
How she just using motherfuckers.
Yeah.
She using you to get your money. She got one dude she's fucking to get weed. Another dude she's fucking to get the pills.
Yeah.
Another one she fucking buying her shit, taking her out to dinner.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Then she's got the one that she loves.
Yeah. Really, because he's beating it up and rude to her, and you know what I'm saying. What it say? The scripture says she's like a snare or a trap.
Yes, a trap, gin.
Yeah,
for a whore, is a deep ditch.
Dark, yeah.
Woo!
Deep ditch. A pit too.
Yeah, it's a pit.
A deep ditch. God, that speaks values, man. That just speaks mad values. Now is she without? Now in the streets. And lieth in wait at every corner. So she caught him and kissed him, and with an impure face said unto him, I have peace offerings with me. This day have I paid my vows. Therefore came I forth to meet thee diligently to seek thy face, and I have found thee. I have decked my bed with coverings of tapestry and carved works and fine linen of Egypt.
Hey, get that proverb.
Fine linen of Egypt. I have perfumed my bed with myrrh, aloes, and cinnamon. Come, let us take our fill of love. Well, baby, let's just go fuck. That's pretty much what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Come, let us take our fill of love until the morning. Damn!
Until the morning.
All right, motherfucker. Let us solace ourselves with loves. For the good man is not at home. Woo! Don't that sound like adultery? For the good man is not at home. He has gone a long journey.
Oh, he's gone. That's why when you go in the military, when I was in the Marines, every dude that had a girlfriend or a wife back home, you see him all one day over there crying, looking on sand.
Right.
My bitch is cheating on me.
Oh, yeah.
Well, hell, my uncle, he was over in Germany, and this motherfucker went AWOL. My dad was telling me he went AWOL, left Germany, somehow got a plane ticket, came back
to hell.
Because his wife was cheating on him.
Yeah, wow. He came back with vengeance.
He came back with vengeance.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, because as soon as you gone,
that was the spirit right there.
Mm-hmm. A bitch can't
AWOL from Germany.
A bitch can't wait for you to leave the house so she can go fuck somebody else, bro. She can't wait.
Come here, baby. Come here.
I know. You know it's true.
You laugh like you get
it. Cause she done been through it. Yeah. She done experienced it.
Mm-hmm.
She can't wait. I can't wait till this raggedy motherfucker leaves. You know what I'm saying? Her bitch and pussy getting wet just thinking about you leaving.
Hey, that brings to mind the perfect movie. You ever seen Black Snake Moan?
Yeah.
Nah, I ain't never seen that.
Bitch, the dude went to the military. Yeah, that's my baby, girl. Man. That's my boo, man. She was fucking everybody.
Christine Ritchie is hot, ain't she?
Yeah, and Samuel Jackson had to literally put a chain on this bitch to tame her, man.
Samuel's in that shit?
Yeah, that's a bad movie, man. Samuel Jackson played the hell out of that
Samuel's
one.
Samuel's in everything.
Yeah, he played the hell out of that
Our
one.
Dad was in Afghanistan when my mom got pregnant.
Damn.
Oh, yeah, I got one of my sisters was that of my father. And here it is, my dad. I mean, I love my dad, but...
Of course.
He's too goddamn forgiving. That's all I can say. And he took that child like it was his own child.
Ain't no fucking way.
You know what I'm saying?
No way.
That's an abomination, man. That's a goddamn abomination.
Ain't no way.
Yeah, right. Yeah, it ain't gonna go down with me either, bro.
There's no, absolutely no way. He hath taken a... Oh, let me read that again. For the good man is not at home.
So really, all these women out here are hoes, man. Your mom's a hoe. Your grandma's a hoe.
Your daughter, your aunt.
Even my grandma had a child that wasn't her. They said one of my uncles wasn't really my grandpa's child.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Everybody got one of those in the family.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
One or two.
And one or two. More, you don't even know.
Yeah, right.
You know what I'm saying? You don't even know.
Yeah, especially if it's, you know, back in the, like, happened in the 50s, 60s.
And that's another good point, too. If you can't prove who is, like, say you can't prove where you're from through a genealogy either, because your family tree going back got all kind of adultery up in it. You know what I'm saying?
Straight madness.
Straight madness. You got adultery, incest. That's part of the curses, man.
That's right. For the good man is not at home. He is gone a long journey. He had taken a bag of money with him and will come home at the day appointed. With her much fair speech, she caused him to yield. With the flattering of her lips, she forced him. He goeth after her straightway, as an ox goeth to the slaughter, or as a fool to the correction of the stocks.
Yep, a goddamn fool. So only a goddamn fool is gonna let one of these bitches sweet talk them.
That got a husband at home.
Because a woman too, they'll get you, to make you feel bad for them. They'll start crying.
Right.
That shit, I don't got no pity for a hoe.
None.
If you're lucky, I'll choke your ass. I end up getting locked up.
Till a dart strike through his liver as a bird hasteneth to the snare, and knoweth not that it is for his life. Hearken unto me now thereof, O ye children, and attend to the words of my mouth. Let not thine heart decline to her ways. Go not astray in her paths. For she hath cast down many wounded. Yea, many strong men have been slain by this bitch.
Many.
By her. Many. I said by this bitch.
Well, you got so emotional while you was reading it.
Right,
that's
right.
Some emotions coming out.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
I know many men that got bitches. Killed, yep. Set up by bitches.
Yep, yep. For real. Her house is the way to hell.
The way to hell? You going? That's a highway to hell right there.
Highway to hell.
On a highway to hell.
Going down to the chambers of death.
That's the chambers of death. Because literally, plus you fucking with a hoe, and when you commit adultery, you get put to death for that, man. You fuck someone's woman. Even you can fuck a bitch that's a known hoe, but somebody else might really like her a lot, and he get jealous because you fucked her too.
Might really love her.
And he'll kill you for it. You know what I'm saying? You see it all the time.
Yep.
All the time.
Yep. Captain Save a Hoe, motherfucker.
Captain Save a Hoe. All you cats are saber hoes, you're gonna get put to death, man.
Spirit, man. I'm glad I ain't never been no had that spirit on that saber hoe type shit, man.
That's I hate y'all, motherfucker. That's how your boy.
There's a true hatred for our enemy, and they are our enemy.
Your boy Polite, he's a supreme captain saber hoe.
Yeah.
He is a hoe. He is a hoe.
Oh, shit. The dude Denzel Washington movies, the Equalizer. He played the ultimate Captain Save-A-Hoe.
Oh, yeah, he said, didn't he?
Yeah, he made, man, that movie is so controversial. He got all kind of white motherfuckers mad at him close to that movie, man.
Why would he do it?
Killing all kind of white motherfuckers in it for that nasty hoe. For a hoe.
Yeah.
It was...
All the Hollywood movies got that
I was surprised,
vibration.
Though, they didn't... they had a little quick scene of her. She wasn't throughout the whole movie, which I was surprised. At first, I thought it was going to be, like, the whole movie... Gonna be like straight up, like just all about her.
The Equalizer.
Yeah, yeah. Think about it. He was helping Issachar out more than that bitch.
Is that a new movie?
The Equalizer.
Yeah.
It's a bad movie.
I don't know.
It is bad as fuck.
Help Issachar to lose that weight.
Oh yeah, the dude he worked with.
Yeah.
In the hardware store.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it was actually helping him more than the white bitch.
Yeah.
Hey, he got that scripture.
He flipped over. He spammed.
They went head over heels over that motherfucker. Yeah. When she got pulled up in that car.
Right.
He went to the crib and started thinking about it and shit.
He just flipped.
13 minutes left on
here.
That
was a cute honey, though, man.
Yeah, she was a cutie.
Hey,
I remember when she was a child, man. When she was a little baby, man.
How long that thing has been going so far? It's got a time meter on it?
The memory card holds 120 minutes in this. We've already only 13 minutes.
Well, it all depends, because... Oh, go ahead. Hopefully it turns into an MP4 this time.
It's been going an hour and 10 minutes.
It's not bad for this fucking freezing ass shit.
Right.
That's nice having them hour and a half long videos, too. It's like watching a movie.
Yeah, that is a movie.
Bring this out.
Proverbs 30:20, such is the way of an adulterous woman.
Such is the way of an adulterous woman. Keep going.
She eateth and wipeth her mouth and saith, I have done no wickedness.
She eateth and wipeth her mouth and said, I have done no wickedness. Now, what's that really talking about, though? You know what that's talking about? No, that's not what that's talking about. It is, but it ain't. What it's really talking about is the Garden of Eden. Hey, let's get that in Genesis, if you will. Somewhere I can get it, you can get it. You know, was that Genesis 3, when the serpent gave the fruit because it was, you know what I'm talking about, right?
Yep.
Because when she ate it and wiping her mouth, that's talking about her eating the fruit that the serpent gave to her. I mean, you can use that to say she's a hoe, she's drinking a nut, and committed adultery and wiped her mouth. I mean, cause that's part of that fruit too, though. Because that fruit represents all that wickedness, you know what I'm saying? Because in America, America is the kingdom of Satan, and all these people out here are eating that fruit or that tree you're not supposed to eat. Okay? Because the fruit, the forbidden fruit in the Garden of Eden represents all those wicked ideologies, philosophies, being an adulteress, being a faggot, you know what I'm saying? Being in the witchcraft, sorcery, all that shit together, man. Yeah. That's that forbidden fruit.
Yeah, the deal that the snake made with him, that promise he made with him.
Yeah, let's bring that out, because it's telling you, I got a preset for that, too.
I got it. But it is a preset, bro. You did get it right, but it's talking about it's referring to her sucking dick, too.
Yeah, it is talking about that.
Swallowing nuts.
Because it's all part of that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Let me read this on 3, and I'm going to start at 1, bro.
Because really, she committed, when you think about it, she committed spiritual adultery against her husband, Adam, when she listened to the snake.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? To listen to the devil. Yeah, it's not an actual snake. It was a wicked, evil person.
A fucking king cobra.
Yeah, right. It was a reptilian. Because some people, I gotta correct that. Some people think that's really a reptilian in the Garden of Eden. That's the same spirit that was in Cain, and the same spirit that was in Esau. It was a wicked, evil man.
This is Genesis 3:1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord power had made.
So the serpent was more subtle. I mean, he's sneaky. He had a, you know what I'm saying? He's very deceitful. Keep going.
And he said unto the woman, yea, has the Most High said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, the Most High has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die.
Lest ye die.
And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die.
Well, the serpent was obviously lying.
Yeah. I got to tell you right there that goddamn woman wanted to be superior. So when he said that, she pretty much said what Adam said.
Yeah, that's the same thing the serpent is doing today, too. The serpent is telling you, being a homosexual, there's nothing wrong with that. Uh-huh. You're not going to die.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Well, you're going to die. You're going to catch AIDS and die. Trust me. You're going to die. You're going to get some bad shit's going to happen to you.
I can't breathe.
Yeah, hands up, don't shoot.
Yeah, but with the serpent, that devil, and what he said to that bitch, man, it just sounded so intriguing, she just couldn't resist.
She couldn't resist.
Yep. More wicked hoes.
Yeah, so that's the serpent. See, the serpent operate on the same MO to this very day.
And
he always tells you
that
all this wickedness has no consequences. But you ain't gonna die, nothing's gonna happen to you.
Shit.
You can be an adultery, you can commit adultery, you can join the church of Satan.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You can do whatever you want.
You got green pus coming out your pussy, but ain't no consequences.
There's no consequences. You can commit adultery all you want.
Yeah.
I mean, it's normal. We're in the age of reason and the age of with the, we're in the modern age.
That's why they got all these goddamn commercials, vaginal commercials and shit.
Yeah.
Every time you turn on the TV, there's some
to fight that herpes shit.
Yeah. And that shit ain't doing about masking whatever.
The HPV.
Yeah.
I guarantee you, like 80% of these women have HPV.
Mm-hmm. Oh God, it's disgusting. And it is a high number like that.
Yeah, it's high, bro.
What's up, Esau?
It's higher than what they say it is.
And the serpent said unto the woman, "Ye should not surely die. For the Most High doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil."
Right.
And when the woman...
Hey, that's the same thing the serpent. Your boy Polite's a serpent, saying a black woman's God.
Exactly.
Madness. That's something the devil would say.
Right.
Keep going.
And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes.
It was pleasant to the eyes. Because all a woman cares about is what she sees.
Mm-hmm. Carnal as hell.
She's carnal. That's why he's talking about that makeup earlier. Mm-hmm. You know, she always went to get her hair done. She got 1,000 pair of shoes. She got a whole closet just for shoes.
Bunch of fucking shoes.
They'll buy a house if the just cost the closet is a walk-in closet.
Yeah, just a walk-in,
You know?
And then she gets sick of the house. Yep. She need a new house.
And got stuck with the motherfucker.
That's why you don't take these people seriously.
It's stupid.
Nigga, me, don't say one thing. And 3 days later, it'll be a whole different motherfucking ball game just because on the strength of how they feel that day.
Yep. The emotional beast. And for the food, and it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat.
All right, I got a precept to back you up. This is 1 John 2:15. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world.
That's right.
We got no love for this world. You know, the hell with this world.
That's right. All the pleasant things and shit.
Yeah, all that pleasant shit. They go into that. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
He's a dead individual.
Yep. But here it goes right here. It says, yeah, the walking dead. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world.
Right.
So that goes back to that fruit, because the fruit was pleasing to the eyes. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
But that's that, like it says, that's the lust of the flesh and the pride of life. Because where Eve had that pride of life, you know, because she listened to the snake. The snake told her she's going to be as a god.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's that pride of life, the lust of the flesh.
Yeah, brother, no light.
And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of God abideth forever.
That's right.
Oh, let me keep going. Little children, it is the last time, as ye have heard, that Antichrist shall come. Even now there are many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time.
That's right.
So we live in a world of Antichrists.
That's right.
Every damn near every person you see is an Antichrist.
And they proud of it too.
A piece of shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? A goddamn devil. You know what I mean? A whore, a faggot. You know what I'm saying? We just surrounded by just wicked people, man.
That's right.
Abominable creatures. Creepy ass crackers.
Right. Creepy disease crackers.
Let me keep going. Well, that's the point on that. That goes into something else. But that's the point, man. The hell with this wicked ass world. Fuck all you adulterous ass whores. I know that camera's about to die. So we pretty much, huh?
4 minutes.
Judgment time coming.
3 minutes.
You know?
Are we good? We got enough for one more scripture.
Judgment time coming for these hoes. And wicked ass two-third niggas that, you know, that encourage these wicked ass hoes.
You got a scripture? Yeah. Bring it out.
You know?
This is our Proverbs.
Tupac niggas.
Oh, they try to say Tupac was a prophet.
Right.
Man.
That's funny.
This is our Proverbs 12:4. A virtuous woman is a crown to her husband, but she that maketh ashamed is a rottenness in his bones.
That's right. Rottenness.
That's right.
That bitch is a goddamn, I know what you said. Yeah, that's why. Rottiness. That's why you notice a lot of married couples, the man will die at the age of 50 because he got so goddamn stressed out. Mm-hmm. And the woman lived to be 80.
Yep. I was just about to say
very
that too.
Often in
this
society.
Just about to say that.
Yeah. Very you the man feel, is you, the first to go.
Yeah, you feel miserable when you got a woman got control over you, man, and ain't nothing you can do about it because you're in love, man. You feel miserable,
but
man.
Really, because a lot of them dudes, they just ready to give the ghost up so they can escape
just
that
get
bitch.
Get the fuck up out of here.
Yeah,
get the
fuck up out of here. Moves.
And I hate to say it, that's how my dad felt when he died, man. He didn't want, he wanted to get away from my mom, man.
Damn.
Yep.
I've been on really numerous did, moves man. Where the woman was just calling the shots. And you'll see the husband, he'll just have this look of disgrace on him, walking around the house with his head down.
Mm-hmm.
He asked him, excuse me, sir, where are you, like this nightstand or something like that?
His
wife.
Yeah, that's just what we read in the Isaiah, the women rule over him.
Ask the wife, she's the boss. With the most disgusted look on his face, like, you know what I'm saying?
That's that vibration. Is the woman's the running the head of the household now. Woman's the head of the household.
Yeah.
That's why the woman gets custody. You think back in our kingdom, back during the medieval times and all that, do you actually think the woman left the husband? She didn't get no kids. Hell no. First of all, a woman wasn't leaving her husband.
That wasn't happening. It was that one scripture, I don't know the top of my head, where it says, through her we all die.
Through her, that's in Ecclesiasticus. And it also said, I'd rather dwell with a lion and a dragon than to be with a wicked woman.
Right.
I'd rather live with a lion. A lion, you know what I'm saying, more friendly than one of these hoes.
There you go. This is Ecclesiastes 25 and 13. Give me any plague, but the plagues of the heart, and any wickedness but the wickedness of a woman.
Yeah, so we just speaking the truth, man. That's what the Bible says. Because the Bible's a manly book, too, like we said. And it's a teacher how to become a real man, not to get hustled by a woman. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You got to be smart. You can't be stupid letting a woman rule over you. If you got a woman, you love her. We ain't saying to go beat the shit out of women and hate women. You know what I'm saying?
Right. So I'm going to jump to 16.
You got to be smart.
I had rather dwell with a lion and a wicked dragon than keep house with a wicked woman. The wickedness of a woman changes her face and darkness her countenance like sackcloth. Her husband shall sit among his neighbors, and when he heareth it, shall sigh bitterly.
Yeah, because, mate, this goddamn Travis, I got a wicked-ass wife make you have a heart attack. That's why you can't let these hoes stress you out, man.
For real.
Just don't even care about it. If you got a woman, just be happy that she's with you for the moment.
Yeah.
And don't get too attached. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
All wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. Let the portion of a sinner fall upon you.
Are you? Because the real woman is his wisdom. Her name is Sophia. You know, Sophia, that's Greek for wisdom.